down to the pool, a puddle, or worse, the toilet. It looks fine from the outside, but what's happening inside?
I know what you're thinking. I'm fine because I have one of these newer phones and it's water resistant. Well, I got news for you. Water resistant is not the same thing as waterproof. No phone is waterproof. So we've come here to You Break, I Fix. These are the experts. They see the water damage all the time. They fix these phones when they can. Jackson Holbrook is here. Jackson, thanks for being here. If I were to open these up at home, how do I know I have water damage?
Most newer devices will have something called a liquid damage indicator. You can see right here, it's bright red.
What color should it be?
Ideally, you would want it to be solid white.
If it's red?
If it's red or even pink, that's an indication that the insides of the device have been exposed to liquid.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. I don't know how to take my phone apart. I'm not doing that. Isn't there any other way to tell if my phone has water damage?
So the first indication that you'll want to look for is any type of audio distortion, either from the speaker or from the microphone. A lot of times if there's water in those components, it will sound like you're talking or listening to something underwater. It'll be garbled and distorted. The other indications to look for are any signs of condensation behind your camera lenses, either on the front or the back of the device.
If it's getting a little foggy.
Exactly. That's an indication that you have moisture inside the device.
So your phone gets wet. What's the one thing people say to do? Put it in rice. True or false?
Absolutely false.
Don't put my phone in the rice.
Not at all.
I was taught to do that. You know, you bury it in the rice like this and it sucks all the water out.
Yeah, it's a very common misconception that rice will save your phone from liquid.
And get this, rice could actually make your phone even worse.
What can actually happen is once the moisture gets inside your phone, the rice is not gonna pull that out. In fact, what sometimes happens is grains of rice can get lodged in your charging port. Sometimes the dust from the rice can find its way into openings on the phone and cause even more problems down the line.
Okay, so rice, no.
Absolutely not. We do not recommend it.
You heard it here first. That's a myth buster. See what I mean? This is my phone covered in it after just sitting in the rice for a few seconds. All right, what should we do?
So first thing you want to do is power the phone off. The biggest risk to phones immediately after exposure to liquid is electricity. The next thing that you want to do is you want to take the phone out of the case. You want to essentially put it face down so that the opening of your ear speaker as well as your microphone and loudspeaker are facing down. You want to dry it on an absorbent cloth like this one right here. And make sure that you remove as much excess moisture as you can. And then finally, you want to take the phone and where there are any openings like on the speaker or the charge port, put it in front of a fan.
Oh, literally that simple?
That simple. And that'll help to dry out the ports and the speakers and the microphones on the device as well as any other openings on the phone.
Do that for about 30 minutes and you should be good to go. And by the way, the type of water matters. Salt and chlorine can accelerate corrosion. So if your phone falls into the ocean or a pool for a long period of time, or if you feel like you just didn't get it dried out enough, just take it into a professional. Get it cleaned the right way. That's all for today. Back to you.